Well, just as a break from working on the A2000, I've been busy doing other stuff, but I thought I'd have a little break and build up this ESR meter. Now, I've got a few capacitance meters, but I realised that it would be really handy to have one of these ESR meters. And so I went to Altronics, and $109 later, I bought the kit with a little case and everything, all the parts except the batteries, and that's the circuit for it. That's what it's going to look like when it's built up. Now, how they work is they put a low level, I think it's 100 kilohertz signal on the two test points and measures the impedance or AC resistance. And typically anywhere from 1 to 20 ohms is what we're looking for. Now, the one failing of them is that if you have a capacitor that's short circuit, it'll measure as a fantastic capacitor. So if you have any doubt, then you need to be able to use a normal resistance meter and on a multimeter, typical one, and see if it's not shorted in DC wise. And if it's not short DC wise, then you know the reading is good. So yeah, I'm looking forward to being able to use it. The other good feature of them, because it's a low level voltage being emitted, it can be inserted into a circuit in situ, and it doesn't turn on any of the transistors and so on. So it's really handy in that respect. You can check capacitors in circuit without having to remove them. So yeah, I'm looking forward to building it up. Hopefully it won't take too long, and I'll show you when I've finished. Ah, I see it uses a Zilog, a ZB6E0412 plus a 4094 CMOS chip and a couple of 7 segment LEDs and lots of transistors and diodes and a regulator, 5 volt regulator. Okay, I'll get to it. That's what it's going to look like. It's quite well made. It's a kit by Silicon Chip and distributed by Altronics, part number K2574. There's a local Altronics shop, and I just went in and bought it in between lockdowns. Pretty much finished doing the circuit board. Yeah, took about about an hour and a half to do. Now do the mechanical assembly. Been milled so it fits in like that. Oh, excellent. Oh, isn't that gorgeous? Oh, this is what happens when you buy kits instead of doing it yourself. Right, so we'll get some glue. Mr. Tarzan's grip will do fine. I'll just do this to get an idea of what it's going to look like and fit together. There's 6 CM pins. Ah, okay, that's for those. Yeah, CM pins go on the component side of this board to solder to. I don't think that's necessary, but yeah, why not? And I'm assuming that these go down the bottom there, stick down. So 9 volts regulated down to 5. I've certainly got some good test equipment lately in the last 12 months. I've been splurging a bit, getting good equipment and a new oscilloscope, and ended up getting more than that, but plus a lot of capacitance meters, more multimeters, a desoldering workstation, a new variac, a couple of 110 volt transformers, a signal generator, one of these little digital things that's quite good. It's have to use buttons to make it work instead of knobs, but it's certainly quite accurate, which is what you want. The other thing is, I'm hoping to get on eBay is a high voltage meter for working on my electrostatics. I was making a kit for myself. I designed it and bought the parts, but I needed to design a circuit board for it, and I never got around to it. So, all right, I think that's it till tomorrow. I'll get back to assembling it tomorrow when the glue's set, do some wiring and so on. See you tomorrow. Well, I've started reassembling it now. Soldering of a few wires, etc. Okay, we're getting there, slowly but surely. Okay, there we are, it's all wired up. The sensor leads, the on-off switch, and the power supply, 9 volts. Now, there's a little test you're meant to do before you insert the ICs. So I took them out to do this. So initial check with IC2 and IC3 out, connect the supply, and we should get about 6 milliamps of current. So we need to do that. And that onto the last battery. Yes, okay. All right, I can do it. 6.6 milliamp. That's perfect. The idea is you measure the current without the ICs, push the red button. Now, I've had to rig a little series effort here, but hopefully, there we go. It's 0. Press the button. And 6.6. Excellent. That means it's working so far, exactly as they say. Okay, it says I should see something, a dash, and sure enough, there it is, a dash. Whoops, it's off doing something else there, but do it again. Yeah, just a dash, okay. Right, keep them, turn it on, and keep it on. Goes 888, then, oh, okay, I think that's it. Just got to be 2/8 for a couple of seconds, and that means it's done its checks. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I think we're right. That means that the board has passed the tests and is probably okay. Now for the calibration. Plug in the test leads. Okay. This is exciting. I'm glad it comes with test leads. Never have enough test leads. Right, they're in. I push the button and we should see a dash. Yes, that's it. That means it's greater than 99 ohms. Short the leads together. Righto. Okay, yeah, 0.24, yes. Push the button again with the lead shorted, should change the display to 0. Yes, okay, that's zeroed it. Connector supplied 68 ohm. Right, that's... We put the probes on it. Oh, it's measuring 71. Oh, we adjust VR2 until we get 68. Okay. VR2 is this one here. Beautiful. Right, now we take that off and use the other resistor, the 5.6 ohm, and apparently it's meant to read it accurately. Oh, look at that, 5.6. Gorgeous. Oh God, what does it want me to do now? Oh, okay. Oh, it's basically a low voltage warning. Yeah, oh, I'm not sure if I could be fagged worrying about that. I think what we could do is just short out one of the... Oh, sorry. Not short out, but remove one of the batteries and work with 7.5 volts instead of 7. I couldn't be bothered connecting up 7 with a variable supply. Slowly turn VR1 until the display brightness suddenly drops slightly and the B warning comes up. Alright, let's see what happens. Oh, it drops slightly. Turn it down. Just suddenly drops in brightness, yes. And the B battery warning indication begins flashing on the right-hand display. Well, it's not doing that. Oh, okay. Ah, I had to have that disconnected. All right, well, that's doing that. I mean, 7.5 volts is good enough. It doesn't have to be 7. Excellent. Well, it's all a goer. Yep, it says here. And that's it. If everything went as planned, you can fully assemble your new ESR meter and start finding defective electrolytic capacitors, blah blah blah. Excellent, that's what I want to hear. Right, now what I need to do is figure out how this goes in here. Something was holding it. Now it's right. Okay, last 4 screws. Connect these up together. Press 0. Now we're zeroed. So let's measure a few caps. A grotty old electrolytic, 1.6 ohms. I guess that's okay. 0.8. Oh, okay. According to this, it's down a bit. It's up a bit, rather. With experience, I'll get to know what's the best. 0.2. Okay, well, that's all right, I think. That's another electrolytic. 100 mic, 63 volt. Right, green cap. It doesn't like anything below 1 microfarad. Oh, mind you, 100 kilohertz. It says here 1 microfarad is the minimum, so I guess... maybe it's not good for anything in the nanofarad ranges. Yeah, I think that's what it is. That's I was expecting too much. 680 and 0.68. Yeah, it's getting up towards the 1 mic. Okay, so looks like a tenth of a mic might be as small as I can use it for. Yeah. Oh, well, that's all right. So, they're okay. All right, just have to... Well, here's a whole heap of electrolytics. Do a few of those. I'll just measure a couple more before I stop. 1.1 is a 47 mic, 63, 38 ohms. Oh dear. That's a 100 mic, 63. So, yeah, that's a pretty cactus, I'd say. Oh, no. Oh, it's changes. Hang on. 0.3. Oh, no, maybe it's all right. Got to make sure I get a good connection. 0.35. Okay. All right, I think we get the idea. It's measuring them all at whatever. Terrific. Of course, the beauty of this thing is that you can use it to measure electrolytics in circuit. I don't know why, but I was thinking it'd be good for the small caps, but I just didn't realise. But that's okay. It's all good. I guess the ones that will be awkward for testing is all the orange caps in Nakamichi's. I don't know if this will be any good for that. I can't remember what values they normally go to. Well, it's good to have this. $109 from Ultronics, kit K2574, $109. And it took me a few hours to put together, but it's now there, ready to use and abuse. Press that, and again, just stop it. Excellent. All right, I'll put a link in the description as to where I got it, and it's up to you if you're interested. It's a good thing to have. Okay, that's it for now. Good night.